I met my Marini through the guy I just knew. At that time, I just knew on Instagram, and he thought that I could maybe try to apply for the job. So I sent you the message, and somehow I got in. When I checked the website of my Marini, I was, wow, this is, I identify so much with this brand. So I was just very excited to get a chance. So, I came here first time in 2015 to do surfing. The following year I wanted to dedicate more time to practice surfing, so I came back to the Safe Surf camp where I was, and I was saying, oh, this is such a cute, lovely place, but I could never imagine myself living here, you know? And then 2 weeks after, while surfing, I met my boyfriend. And then after half a year of back and forth, we decided that I will be moving here, you know? Maybe it's my focus that shifted, because as time went by, I felt more and more passionate about longboarding, and then I just preferred to spend my time and energy on it. So I felt it was a bit two things, both my focus and my motivation and my passion with longboarding, and very cold water in the Atlantic. Before moving to Portugal, I was living in Finland, and that's where I actually started longboarding. And when I was about to move to Portugal to live with Johnny, I was very excited, not only to be with Johnny, but also I thought, oh, Portugal has 300 sunny days a year, and for sure there will be finally a longboard community I can join, and to have company, to have somebody I can learn from. And then I arrived here and I just realized that there is nobody doing longboard dancing and freestyle. I was always complaining to Johnny that I have nobody to skate with, I have nobody to learn from, and he was saying, why don't you create something? And in June 2017, we hosted the first longboard meeting here in Santa Cruz together with association. And the funny part, we were thinking, oh, it will be just me, Johnny, and the person from the organization showing up. And we were about 30 people, and everybody just was so stoked about it, you know? And that's where we felt that, okay, there is a need. And suddenly we felt that people really want to have something happening, and people are eager to participate. And from then on, so June 2017, these were monthly events. Then in 2018 came the camps, and we got some of the world's best longboarders visiting that beautiful place by the ocean. It was very funny, because when we were organizing the first event, this girl, Joanna, she told me, we will make Santa Cruz known around the world for longboarding. And I was like, yeah, of course, no, no way. And now it's true that somehow it started to be, I think, a special spot for many longboarders. Maybe a longboard mecca of Portugal? I don't know, at least very symbolic place, yeah. The Korean rider through whom I discovered longboard dancing, came here to skate, and I see him skating at the spot, and I'm like, wow, is this real? Is this real? Because it's kind of life made a loop, you know? I was watching him on Vimeo video and it seemed like another world, and then suddenly he was skating here. It's exciting that we got people from 20-year-olds to 60-year-old, you know, men, women from 25 countries, starting from Malaysia, Japan, USA, Russia, Europe. I started longboarding in 2014 was the first time I stepped on it, and 2015 when I was getting more and more into it. And at that time I was actually in a pretty difficult place with my body, and I was struggling with eating disorder, and somehow longboarding came with a very good time for me, because it was a way for me to enjoy my body more without putting pressure. And longboarding really helped me to reconnect with myself and with my body, to appreciate my body more, because you just see how much joy your body can give to you. I also started to find my voice through it. It started to be my platform, or my voice, to communicate with many other people, to maybe to empower them, to inspire them, to show them that they can do more than they imagine. So longboarding has also been a tool for me, maybe to bring something to this world. I couldn't find a phrase to describe my life, but I would say this phrase from a song which says, "If life gives you a chance to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance, I hope you dance," which is more about when living life to the fullest and being courageous and trying new things, having your heart open. So this is something that I try to live by.